Hi everyone, Dale Pinkert, mentor of the Eagle's Nest. You can find me on Twitter at Forex Stop Hunter if you're interested in my mentoring you and teaching you how I come to some of these conclusions and forecasts. I want to start off with the dollar. I'm believing that there's still the potential for one more decline in the dollar. I'm wrong over the highs that we posted on the 17th. Of June, so that would be the 97.80 level. The potential for the market to sell off one more time, part of the reason is I think we need a lower dollar to generate one more wave up in the upside in S&Ps. S&Ps have to hold 29.60. I'll be there after this, and it would be a more benign environment for the dollar to sell off a little bit. So we have Powell talking. We'll see how dovish he is in the next couple of days. My bet is for a lower dollar, a turnaround Tuesday special around here, wrong over 97.80, initially looking for 96.86, the first green line. If we could penetrate that, 96 will be challenged and taken out for perhaps the long-term buy in the dollar. So that's what I'm looking at this week in the dollar. Moving on to the S&Ps, which I just mentioned, we had a sell-off from the big round number of 3,000, something else that was forecasted on several contributions over the last month or so. To me, it looks like the potential still exists for another push to the upside. It's going to be very important, as you can see, that first red line at the 29.60 level is going to be real critical for the market to hold. If we take that out, then perhaps this correction is underway and we could trade all the way back down to 28.90. My bet is one more high coming up here. I've been talking about mid-month July as a GAN date for at least a trading reaction, and it would take, I believe, a weaker dollar and maybe a little softer rates, although I believe the rates are also in a bottoming process and yields will begin to rise. In fact, the yield curve, instead of inverting, we could look for some steepening there based upon what I'm seeing in my work. So S&P's 29.60, very critical. Still think 30.40, 30.50. The whole world's looking for that number. What I've learned about these numbers is when the whole world's looking for one number, it either never achieves it or it becomes a meaningless technical level. So we'll see when, if we get up there. Last week, I talked about crude selling rallies up towards the 58 to 58 and a half level. We put in a pretty negative candle up there after trying to take out the moving average at 58. 58.03 is my 2 week off number. That would confirm the downtrend. Still believe that there's a test coming of at least the 54 level. As you can see by that speed line, if I extend it out there, would take it to the 54 level. We had a $2 bounce from 56 to 58 and a half. So the potential for the first break that we had was $4 from 60 to 56, $4 from today's high, takes you into that 54 area. So good hunting, everybody, good luck. And if you're interested in learning how to trade and applying some of my simple yet powerful trading techniques with RSI and three drive formations, just send me a message on Twitter at Forex Stop Hunter. Be happy to work with you. Adios, good hunting, and remember, don't just count your pips, count your blessings. Adios.